Hi, I'm Matt Watts, and welcome to another edition of What's the Future? In this episode, we're going to talk about some of the areas of AI that people are probably more concerned about. We've called this episode AI-AI-O, as in Old MacDonald, and that's going to be stuck in your head for the rest of the day. We're going to cover three things, though. We're going to talk to a chief information security officer about how they think about security with AI coming along. We're going to talk to somebody in creative about how they consider the impact potentially to be for their people. And we're going to talk about overcoming some of the challenges to be able to really exploit the benefits of AI. AI introduces a number of new challenges. Unlocking the power of AI is almost completely dependent on the data that fuels it. Accessing, governing, and using data in a continuous cycle. And that cycle builds more value as more data is analyzed and put to use. When running your own AI instance, the more data and context you feed it, the better the generative response is. But this process is easier said than done. Not only is the volume of data massive and unrelenting, it's scattered, often unstructured, and always a security risk. Protecting against sensitive data exposure, bias, model anomalies, malicious hacking requires diligence. We also have to consider the sustainable management of data infrastructure that supports the model training and deployment. The race to adopt is understandable, but it is much easier to address data privacy early on rather than face non-compliance later. The data management challenges presented by AI make it essential for companies to adopt an intelligent data infrastructure. But what does AI mean for the creative process, for the content creators inside organizations? Well, let's check in with a great colleague of mine, Emma Reeve. Emma is, by trade, a customer experience and content expert, a so-called creative. She is the VP of content at NetApp and is a key player in our storytelling strategy. Hey, Emma, good to see you.
Nice to see you, Matt, or at least this version of you.
Emma, I'll cut right to the chase. Are you worried that AI is going to start taking the jobs of content teams?
Listen, AI fundamentally changes the way that we create value. Today, we start thinking, we build a strategy, we reimagine until it's absolutely perfect. This takes time and people. But to answer your question, it's not going to replace the writers just quite yet. It'll help speed our creation process and nuance, even getting into the details. But you can still tell the difference between machine-made and human storytelling.
What does this mean for you and your team and the writers out there?
I think traditional labels don't really apply anymore. We've got access to tools that can equip us to write and design and direct, but there's still a level of judgment and wisdom that AI can't replicate. Now, AI saves us time for parts of that process, and overall, it improves quality.
And to drive it home further, the innovation and adoption of AI is moving at a pace that is hard to comprehend. In fact, the technology used to create me only became widely available quite recently since we started creating these videos. And now here I am, able to look like Matt, talk like Matt, and with the wonders of AI, I can even begin to think like Matt too.
Okay, this is kind of getting a bit weird and scary. I think we should talk to a security officer. So, hey, Mignona.
Hey, Matt.
What are one or two of your biggest concerns when it comes to security and AI?
Oh, well, I have several big concerns, but my main one is training AI to have bad behavior. So what if I have a malicious person and that they start training the system to actually do things that are incorrect and it goes undetected? And then the other main concern, if I think about it, is what if we miss something? So what if we have trained models and there's issues out there that we've never thought of that the model would not capture?
So what should people be thinking about when it comes to things like ChatGPT and large language models and AI?
Well, the main thing that comes to mind, Matt, is how we can use it to actually start mimicking the thoughts of a threat actor, being able to see the early signals of how a threat actor will progress through an environment. So you can see the early signals and then actually know if something may come towards you and start putting protection mechanisms in place.
That's great. Thanks, Mignona. So I guess this only really leaves us with one more question, which is who comes back for the next episode? Is it me or MetaMatt?